Welcome back, it's still Your View on TVC. Celebrity marriage breakup is not only alarming, but it leaves us wondering if really the concept of a perfect match still exists among celebrities. There is a trend of celebrity marriage breakup from Nollywood actress Inedo to Funke Akindele amidst orders. Taking a cue from Tibley's and Tiwa's marriage scandal, we ask, could it be difficult to find love as a celebrity? What should celebrities do to maintain a successful marriage? Give us your view and let it count by calling us on 070-8066-8014. Or you could tweet to us at TVC Connect, that is TVC with double C, Connect, and hashtag your view on TVC. We'd like to hear from you. Now, Jiboke, why are you jumping? Why are you jumping? I can decide not to make you see anything on this show today.
I'm just reminding you, you asked two questions. Go ahead.
So, it's Celebrity Friday, we are allowed.
She's booking your children.
No, but we're talking about finding love as celebrities. And I actually want to start with you because you're the only one single amongst us. And you're a TV person, very vocal. How has it been getting into relationship even after being on TV?
Two questions you asked, that can it be difficult? Yes, it can be difficult to find love as a celebrity. You don't know who to trust. Why are they interested in me? Is it because of me or they want to be a part of this celebrity? The second one is, what do they have to do? The other thing you need to do that I found has worked for me is to leave your celebrity outside of your home. Meaning that all the anti-Funmi hair and plenty makeup and diva attitude, leave it for photo shoots. Or when you are on TV, when you get to your private life, be yourself and be natural.
Personal question.
So I answered your two questions, and I'm going to answer the personal question. I don't run away from these things.
Okay.
My man came onto me without knowing that I was on TV,
okay,
which is where my second answer comes in, because in my personal private life, I am still very grounded as Jumoke. Once I step out of TVC, I'm back to Jumoke, my flip-flops and my shorts. I'm an event person. I don't have time. I'm a behind the camera person. So I don't have time to be heavily made up all the day or thinking about my hair. That's why I've had dreadlocks for 12 going on 13 years. I don't have time to focus on frivolity. I'm a real down to earth person. So when he even found out that
you're on TV. So he didn't know you were a
celebrity.
No,
he didn't
person.
Know.
Okay,
so
that
it was
means
more like
it's
TV
not really
person.
To
yeah.
You. But
you just have to stay true to who you are.
I want to ask your own in a different way. I know you've worked in media for many years, so you've seen celebrities firsthand. You've seen them single, you've seen them married. What do you think, it's difficult for a celebrity to find love? How would they know it is true love and not just somebody trying to be with me?
Just as you said, when you are a celebrity, it's more difficult, granted, because when people are attracted to you, most times they're attracted to you because of the
persona.
Hype. You know, because of the hype. And it's difficult for you to know which one of them is for real. And when you eventually find the one that is for real, now the celebrity herself or himself needs to be able to, just as she said, remove her person from the celebrity image. And some people have become so good at being celebrities that it's difficult.
To be regular individuals.
They've become so good. She's able to go into her flip-flops. Some are
immediately.
Not. Some are not able to remove the divaness.
Yes,
if there's a word like that from them. So they take it from the studio, they take it from the set, and they take it home. They take it to church. They take it to the market. That's why you find some celebrities always having problems. You know, they're always being nasty. Why are you being nasty? This is real life.
I agree.
Be yourself, all right? I don't think, because if the moment you find yourself, the moment you know that you are a human being outside the facade of celebrity, you're able to dig deep into yourself and find yourself, it's easier for you to now build a relationship with someone. Because you can leave that outside and then you come in, you're you.
Wow. I know she's going to take some psychological.
It's not psychological, no.
Or biblical.
I think it's a function of what you make of what you want. Now, when you say that is difficult, I would disagree. I don't think it's difficult. I think if you want to make it difficult for you, that is when it will become difficult. Because when you are a celebrity, you are a person first before you're a celebrity, and you had friends. You understand? So if you are somebody that is genuinely honest with yourself, you're not somebody that tries to be who you're not, that is when it will be difficult, because you attract who you are. The people that are pretentious and those kind of people are the kind of people you continue to find around you.
No,
I was telling my friend something, because the wedding I attended yesterday, by the way, shout out to her husband, it's his birthday, Mr. Bashar. You know, I was telling her something, and she, you know, we were talking. I said, how come women that that go through, like, what's it called, cheating and all that, how come they don't, I don't have them as friends? I don't have them as friends because it does not have a landing pad in on my inside.
That is you.
I'm saying, I mean, with her, it's the same thing. Mm. So for me, as a celebrity, if I choose now not to be true to myself, forget about that, whether I'm a celebrity, I'm humble or whatever, there is a limit to which I will, you know, know that I am truly honest with myself. Because before you became celebrity, Chris, you had friends, you had people. They know your personality. A man is only attracted to your character. A man is attracted to who you are as a person. Not whether you are a celebrity or not. There are some celebrities that are still very, very grounded. They are still very humble.
And it is easy for them. We are saying the same thing.
We are saying
the same thing, because if you dig deep, just as you say.
That's what I'm saying.
You
it's deep, not difficult.
But it is.
It's not.
No, I want to point out
something. A lot of people
something.
That come to you are attracted to you because of that.
That is the point.
No.
Who are just really?
Truly.
Character does not hide.
I'm not talking about the ones that you had before you became a celebrity. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about the ones
that meet you.
That's what I'm saying.
Because if you already had a relationship before the celebrity thing came in, it's a different thing because you've already been in the relationship. Now, what we'll be talking about is not, is it difficult for you to start a relationship? It should not be, is it difficult for you to keep your relationship? And
let
that is where,
that's different
where, that's where when you now, a lot of people do not know how to handle celebrity. They don't know how to handle. That's why I said some people become so good at being celebrities,
that
they forget
easy, it's
themselves.
For them to not become themselves.
So that now becomes their reality.
You see, when you are a celebrity, we're on TV for an hour. Considering someone who is probably an actress or an artist of a Tiwa status, who performs, who is probably doing video shoot today, in the studio tomorrow, you don't have a life outside that celebrity cocoon. You wake up in the morning, is go to the studio. Your producer is there beside you. Your manager is there beside you. Everything you're doing is planned for you. Pre-marriage. Mm. How do you even meet somebody that is not seeing you as a cash cow?
Well, we are TV presenters, not celebrities, like you rightly put it, because a celebrity, the way they would approach you, a TV presenter, is just acknowledging that I see you on TV. But a music star, an actress, an artist, the way they will approach them like they're demigods. It's a different approach. Mm. So, but you do have your private life.
Everybody does.
Go ahead, pick your call.
All right, we'll have Shola from Ketu. Welcome to the show. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning, ladies in the studio.
Good morning.
Actually, honestly, Uwa has spoken my mind this morning. You see, the celebrity, they make it difficult for themselves to get the right love. Number one, if a celebrity wants to get the right love, let her bring down her pride. Most of the celebrities we have in Nigeria wants to go for celebrity like them. If they can come down to any man, I'm not saying they should accept any
how would they meet the man?
But if they can come down to any man if they can come down on any man that came their way, I think they can find full love. That is my contribution.
Thank you. Thank you,
Shola. Meet different men on a daily basis. It's how to trust what the person is really looking for. And you want love for love. You don't want love for who I am on TV or me being a star. You want to be real. But I think that the major issue that we need to address is you have to, for instance, in Tiwa and T-Bill's issue, you must, as a celeb who finds a man who is interested in you, have what your goals for marriage are written out. What are your expectations for such a marriage? Okay. Do you go for marriage counseling? To the extent, let me reach where I'm going to. To the extent that In our society, for instance, a man expects that a woman will cook. And because you're a woman who's always on the road, you expect your husband to understand you. If that expectation is not addressed before marriage, you get into marriage and you have the issue that TBU's had is his wife. She's not cooking for me. But if you had spoken about it, but if sadly, you don't go for marriage counseling.
Sadly, even outside being a celebrity, a lot of regular people don't have marriage goals. Don't even think of marriage in terms of the issues they might face. Don't prepare adequately for marriage.
But so if you go for that, counseling, that the counselor should help you, guide you in that light.
I'm happy about the show, what we're going to do today, which is going to be reorientating and educating people about how to prepare for marriage and finding love. We have a professional in the studio who would shed more light on this, help us to understand how a celebrity can find love. And I'm sure even regular people like you and I can find tips on this that would be practical and be useful for our everyday life. Stay with us, we'll be right back. Welcome back. Still discussing how to find love as a celebrity. Joining us is a family life coach, Mrs. Julie Mobo. She said she doesn't want the Mrs. She just wants to be Julie Mobo. Julie Mo. So on the show today, you are Julie. We are the Julie Mo family.
Yeah.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you. She did, actually. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure being here.
Now, you've heard our own take on the discussion. What I summed up from what all the ladies have said is that if you are yourself and you know yourself, it should be easy, even as a celebrity, to find love. What's your opinion on finding love?
I actually will go with Ua on her point. It's actually not difficult.
Oh, really?
Life shouldn't be difficult.
Shouldn't.
It shouldn't be difficult, yes. But there's a problem somewhere, and I would want to take it from the system that actually is responsible for churning out the products that we find in different areas in the world today. Mm. Those you find in the entertainment industry, those you find in the economic sector, those you find in the education sector, are all products of a system, and that is the family. Mm. So what's our first introduction of or to who we are? What do we know first about what love is? What do we learn about what relationship is? We get to be introduced to these things right from home.
Okay.
So that's our first introduction. We are being conditioned to live and expect a particular kind of thing from people.
Okay.
From home, we learn trust. We learn what trust is. You only trust people that have your kind of skin. You only trust people that worship in or belong to your own kind of religion. You only trust people that are from your own ethnic group. In short, you narrow it from the state to your local government. And recently a friend of mine, he's been a friend for over 10 years, wants to get married. And honestly, I was surprised when he told me he was actually looking for someone from his village. Uh-huh. Where did that come from? From home. You're made to believe that every other lady from any other state is good enough. Yes, a good enough wife.
So how do you relate this to being a celebrity? That the things around the celebrity might block her from finding love easily or block him from finding love?
There are certain things that intercept their lives, and whatever kind of upbringing they had, we need to just keep taking it back there.
But
plays out, yes.
The example you gave now, isn't it not just a matter of choice? Okay, the fact that he wants to marry someone from his village as opposed to one who wants to marry a Ghanaian woman, for instance.
Finding love
doesn't mean that because I choose to marry someone from Ghana, I was better brought up at home? Or
no. Were you exposed to the knowledge that you could also find good persons in every other place? Now, this is what you were exposed to. This is your focus. That's the best you know.
Yeah.
If you had other options, if you were told that you can have good friends, if you were even allowed to be friends with everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And then you can
let me take a cue from what she said.
You could still decide, yes.
I am married to someone that is from Adamawa State. I was born in Kaduna State. I grew up all my life, adult life in the north, until I now went to the university. And we now met. We met actually in Benin. And anytime I say I'm married from the north, you know, it's like, it's common. Because what she's saying is that I am comfortable. There are some people that will not even stand another tribe.
They will not.
They will not stand it. So you see, that's why
it's a personal choice.
You see, Chris,
she's saying that the personal choice is based on what you were exposed to.
It's based on what you were exposed to.
Yesterday,
you know why I'm saying that? Yeah. I'm so sorry. I'm saying that because of my own experience. Mm-hmm. I'm married to a Benin man. My whole life was in the north. I was more exposed to the Hausas, to the northerners, you know. I schooled, I did my service in the north, but I ended up marrying a Benin man. So I don't think it's a matter of, I think it all boils down to choice, regardless of where you were brought up. That's what I'm talking
about. So
where
does the place of choice coming from now?
Yeah.
Now, of course, it's when you're growing as a person, you get to get exposed to people, you learn things, you watch TV, then there's always that place. That's why it's important for you to know, first of all, who you are, you know what you want in life. So regardless of the kind of conditioning, regardless of the kind of upbringing that you have, if you stay true to yourself, you know what you want in life, you can. Now, that's where choice comes in. You decide for yourself, this is the road I want to take, this is the path. And even if there isn't something like that, you go ahead to create it. If there aren't opportunities for you to meet the kind of person you want, you create that opportunity. Perhaps around you, you probably want to find, that's why I actually counsel singles and kind of prepare them for marriage. And then you have a mind of marrying a white person. But all around you, you're surrounded by dark people.
You used to.
You go to a religious home, dark people are there, but you have this dream. You just want to marry a white man. And your environment is not telling you, is not suggesting to you that
it's
to change your environment. So you have to create that opportunity. Either you go through, watch TV, go on the internet, expose yourself.
And I ended up marrying a tribe that I couldn't stand.
So well, can I say something? You know, I want to ask a question because we're focused on the negatives of all the celebrity breakups. Dakore, for instance, she got married, and of course, the first few years of her marriage, there were ground rules that the man said, you know what, I don't want you to be in the public eye for a bit, blah blah blah. And of course, now she's back into the public view. Where is the place of your character? Because that's the point I think I'm trying to project. A lot of these celebrities, you know, from afar, I idolize the person. She looks very good. I think this one will make a good wife material. Until they now come one-on-one with you and now realize that this person has nothing inside of them. So is character not playing a major role in this fact that, okay, they're finding it difficult getting the right partners?
You know, the celebrity thing, just like you said, is just a smoke screen. It's not real. It actually isn't real. We do not, the world in which we live in does not promote, does not applaud true character.
Thank you.
No. So you just feel that you need to fake it in order to make it. You need to put on all of the glamour and all that in order to fit in. Now, if you're able to stay true, people don't even do interviews. Now, let me just paint this scenario. You want to start up a business and you know you're busy, you can't be there, you need somebody to sit there. You can't just pick anybody from anywhere, not even a jobless person. Joblessness is not an experience. So you need to get someone that is doing something already and you're sure that this person can handle this position. And you keep your eye on it. You let the person undergo some series of interview. You ask, and you could actually seek for a second, third opinion. Do you know this person? You ask for referee. You ask for someone to be referred to you. But then when we want to make a choice of a partner, we just assume. No, this person looks good. This person will fit in. this person, this person.
Is that not where the difficulty arises? That's why we say it's difficult.
It shouldn't be if from the beginning.
In a perfect world. In a perfect world, it shouldn't be.
It shouldn't be from the beginning. If from the beginning things are done right.
Mm.
If the engineering of a person's mind is dysfunctional.
Mm.
When the foundation is faulty, what do you expect? The building will collapse no matter how beautiful or how.
And I like what you said about the society does not value true character.
Right, Jumoke, your question.
I have a question. We talk about celebrity breakups because they're in the public eye, but there are a lot of single, matured women and men today. So when you talk about character, does it mean that everyone has got a character flaw? Why are there more single, matured people today than we've ever had?
Okay. Now, we hear things like, once you get to 30, or a particular age, for the female, your biological clock is ticking. And at that point, if the woman herself isn't married before 30, she begins to look down herself and begins to think that, okay, she can't get married, and either becomes desperate. And a man who knows where he's going to, if he senses
desperation. I'll cut you off there.
Okay.
You'll continue in that line. We'll take a quick break. Stay with us, we'll be right back. Welcome back. Now, Julie Moore, you were explaining how when you cross 30, women start getting a little desperate and men sense the desperation. That was where I cut you off.
Yes, that's for women who actually haven't discovered why they were created. They have not discovered their reason for being given life. They don't know what their purpose in life is. So you find some getting desperate at that age. And then when a man who has a direction in life already knows what he wants, he comes in contact with that kind of a person, he would want to pause. He would want to think again. So when that comes in, you find out that they begin to look for singles like them. Someone was saying something here. You find yourself, okay, I'm not married. Let me look for another single person, and you just keep rolling. What do
around
you want in life?
People.
Yes. What do you want in life? Just move.
Are single men desperate also then?
She can answer that after we take this call. Lara is calling from Songo. I don't want to keep you waiting for too long. Lara, welcome to the show. Good morning.
How are you doing?
Very good, thank you.
Welcome back, Dokwen.
Thank you so much, Lara. So what's your take?
My own contribution is, the reason why some celebrities are not finding the right husband, is because they are not submissive.
They are not?
They are not submissive. The Bible told us that in the book of Proverbs, that woman be submissive to your husband.
Mm.
The man, you should love your wife as Jesus Christ loved the church. Look, let us take Omotola Jolade as a case study. I learned that she has already celebrated her 20 years marriage anniversary. It is celebrating also. It's because she danced to the tune of her husband. That's why she can celebrate 20 years of her marriage.
They danced to
Jesus. In the case of Tiwa Savage and CJ, they didn't reach a compromise before they go into marriage.
Mm.
That's my own conclusion.
Thank you, Lara. I think they danced to each other.
Can I read some tweets?
Okay.
Sorry. Oluwatoyin says, celebrity marriage is more or less like a showbiz, too. Many probably see marriage as acting or as being on set. Then Mary Esther says, life shouldn't be difficult, but it is. It is difficult finding love as a celebrity because you don't know who truly loves who loves you truly. Then Ngochi Nsofo says, "Oh, I love your views/opinions on this hot topic. You speak based on reality and not being sentimental. You have sound morals." Then Prince says, "Our celebrity should not just be jumping on marriage anyhow, because marriage is not a career."
We have a call, Reverend Bode.
Okay.
Reverend Bode, welcome to the show. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning, Zofa. How are you doing today?
Very good, thank you.
Good morning, ladies. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
It's such a great time to be on your show today. I've been trying you for so many years.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. You see, I just want to make this contribution that our society, people place a lot of expectation on people.
Mm.
And that's the reason why a lot of celebrities don't really get married. Because if you're high up there, what kind of a person are you looking for? Let me ask you a question. If you knew everything you knew about yourself, would you want to marry somebody like you?
True.
If you are a celebrity, what kind of a person are you?
True.
Are you looking for somebody like yourself or someone who is better than you? So a lot of celebrities live this fake life. And so you don't really get what you want. So let me ask you, maybe Uwa, my very good friend, like you a lot, or maybe let me ask Tope, if you knew everything you knew about yourself, would you marry someone like yourself? That's the question we should ask ourselves. And that's why a lot of celebrities do actually don't get married. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, I actually like the question he asked because it's about it was you know, it was good for me. And because he threw it at both of us, I would like to answer it that I knew where I was going to be in future. I had a picture of what I was seeing in my future. And I had other suitors apart from my husband that looked glossy at that point in time when I was thinking of getting married. But because I knew where I was going to be, I knew they wouldn't fit in and won't help me get there. So it brings us to the point of knowing who you are and who you want to be. But when it comes to celebrity, and I want you to give us points, because a lot of celebrities, we're learning from celebrities, but we also need points for individuals. A lot of people are watching that are single and they need to know how to prepare for marriage. Mm-hmm. How do you find love? How do you take your love through test to be sure that this is the true love? Okay. Maybe in like a bullet point, because we don't have much time.
First of all, you need to discover your...
We have a phone call, please. Oh. Sorry. So let me, before you answer, okay. Yakub, welcome to the show. Good morning. Yeah. Is it our Yakub?
Good morning, Mama. Yay. Yeah, welcome back to the studio.
Thank you.
Oh, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, and the two gentle ladies. You see, the last caller said something very, very important. But to me, I don't think it's possible. There's no way you will likely to marry somebody like you. It can never happen. Because you are both of you, you're born from different homes. There's no how you can have the same character. The problem, I think, to all these celebrity issues is, imagine when you put your marriage in social media, what do you expect to happen? The guy that you brought the day before yesterday, he said something very, very important. I love that man because I don't know who gave you the man contact number before you brought him to the studio. I would like you people to bring that man because every time the man appears in this studio, we ought to learn a lot. Because he said something. You see, a man does not like somebody who competes with him at home. Because when you are trying to tell your husband that this is what you want and then he must die to your tone, they are going to bring a lot of problems between both of you. And then, Topper, please, give me 1 minute. Let me just say this. There's a newspaper, when you are reviewing this paper day before yesterday, you mentioned one thing very, very important. You said the House of Assembly, they wanted to sign in the law whereby they will kill anybody that kidnapping or something. What stopped them to bring the same law to people that take away all our money? What?
Yakub, thank you.
Very quickly, first of all, you need to know who you are, know where you want to go to. Then you need to understand what the concept of family is, know what family is, know what marriage is, know who a man is, know who a woman is, then know who a wife is, who a husband is, know who a father is, and who a mother is. You need to have all of this first of all. Now, these are the ways and the things that you can use to carry out interviews. Now, that's
his response to fatherhood.
Yes.
His response to responsibility as a husband.
Responsibility as a husband. Now, there's this issue. One of the callers mentioned something about submissiveness, and that is one topic, one aspect, one area that has been
missed. That we need to make a full topic.
Yes. It's a different topic on its own. And what that's the only language you hear so many men say, my wife is not submissive. My wife is not submissive.
Don't
respect
me.
That's the scripture. That's that aspect that they bring out. Now, what is submissiveness? Does it mean that the woman has no purpose, has no vision? Now, she comes in, she loses herself. If that's what being a wife is, not so many people, I wouldn't even want to be a wife. If I would lose my individuality because I have to get married. So you need to understand, first of all, what is my wife bringing in? She's bringing in something. If she's going to help you, where are you going? She needs to get to that level. to also to be able to compliment you. That's why you find some men will have official wives and they have wives on the other side. Now, so you should be able to bring your wife, groom your wife to a level that will match with your status if you are up there. Mm. So if your wife is a celebrity, you need to, you are there already. You need to understand, you know what this takes. Now let's come to a compromise. The issue of cooking shouldn't even come in. You are a human being, for crying out loud. You were eating from when you were a child. Okay. You should do chores as a boy. Okay, my father taught me how to cook.
What I'm learning, what I'm getting from you, and I think all of everybody watching is also getting, is the fact that when you define what you want first, then you now take your spouse, and because we know that this happens to both male and female, so you ask he or she, who are you as a man, or as a woman, then the husband and wife rule, so that you go, because love alone might not, is not necessarily all you need for marriage to be successful.
Because we keep singing this song, submissiveness, being submissive. Being
no,
submissive.
Yeah, don't go there,
but,
Chris.
No,
don't
I
go
want
there.
To say something.
Chris,
no,
the topic.
I just want to say one single thing.
Say very fast.
How easy is it for a woman to submit to someone who is meant to be a man, but is not a man? Because men also ought to check themselves. No, men also ought to check themselves. Because it's easy for them to
say,
it's easy for them to say,
we don't have time. What I want you to do is to give us a last word concerning Tiwa. Yes, and I want it in like 30 seconds.
What I want to say is that, you see, over the years, we have decided to categorize a man as a man only when he can provide for us. That doesn't make him a man. So we should change that definition. If a man does not have money today, does not mean he will not have money tomorrow. So when
money.
You say that a man is not doing what he's supposed
that's
to do
not
as
what
a man,
I said. That's not
what
I
is
said.
Your definition?
That's
I need
what
you
I
to clarify
said.
That because that is what happened
a man.
Your last word.
No, your last word. She's not letting me talk.
Your last word.
A man does not have to make money to be a man.
Okay. So you need to define
other
attributes. Okay. Better.
She won't let me talk.
To find love, seek God first, because he's the originator, he's the author and the finisher of our faith, and he created marriage for man to find help, so the two of them becoming one will achieve his own aims. So we need to seek God first, and he will direct us in the right way. If somebody comes to you with pretense and you are in the house of prayer, God will show you who the real person is. So let's seek God first.
That's a fantastic way to round off the show. Seek God, know yourself. Join us next week. Thank you so much, our guests. Today's show will be filled with so much information and we're out of time. Thank you so much for coming. It was a fantastic show. We hope to bring you back some other time. And thank you, ladies. It's been a great week. Thank you, viewers, for watching. See you next week. Have a great weekend. Bye.